Hello everyone. Today we will begin with 9th standards lesson 1.2, a synopsis, The Swiss Family Robinson. First of all, what is synopsis? Synopsis is a brief summary of a novel or a play. It is an outline of its basic story. The Swiss Family Robinson is a book containing the fictional, that is imaginative, adventures of a family written by Johann David Wyss. The story contains a family of six, a father, a mother, and four sons. The father's name is William, and he is not only brave, knowledgeable leader of the family, but also the narrator of the story. His wife, Elizabeth, is intelligent and resourceful. She takes with them a magical bag full of supplies, including sewing materials and seeds. She can also cook a meal out of almost everything, from porcupine to penguin. Their oldest son, Fritz, is 15 years old. He is intelligent like his mother. He is brave too and accompanies his father into potentially dangerous situations. After Fritz, there's Ernest, who is 13 years old. He is more intelligent than Fritz, but less active, and so he doesn't go with William as often. Next comes Jack, who is 11 years old. He is bold and thoughtless. Jack is quick thinker. Franz is the youngest member of the Robinson family. He is only 8 years old and typically stays with Elizabeth, that is mother. Understanding the main characters is crucial for understanding the book. The story begins with the six Robinsons aboard a ship. The ship is in rough seas during a storm, and the other passengers evacuate the ship. Evacuate means left the ship to save themselves, leaving the Robinsons to survive on their own. The family survived the night in the ship's hold, that is, space in ship for cargo. After surviving the night, the family sees a tropical island ahead. So they decided to get to the island. They could see beyond the reef, that is, rocks and sand close to the surface of the sea. So with much effort, the family constructed a vessel, that is, a boat, out of tubs. They filled the boat with food and ammunition and all other articles of value they could safely carry. Then they rowed towards island with two dogs from the ship named Turk and Juno swimming along beside them. The family landed successfully on the island. Once they made it through landfall, they constructed a tent. This was their first home. They cut and spread armloads of grass to serve as their beds and soften the floor of the tent. William and Fritz took gourds and cut them into different utensils. After a few days, mother wished to shift the family to a safer place because their current camp was not only exposed but also very dry and hot. She wanted a house that would be safe from jackals and other animals. Elizabeth's decision to move to a safer place shows her foresight and knowledge of the environment. It also shows her intelligence. So they built their second home, that is, a tree house. Their second home was a tree whose trunk was nearly 40 feet in diameter. The branches were long and extended straight out from the trunk, making them perfect platforms for a structure. After determining the height of the lowest branch from the ground, they made a ladder. In this process, the father taught boys geometry and how to use triangles to measure big objects. He measured a defined distance from the trunk. Then he calculated angles using several measured rods, determining that the lowest branch was 30 feet off the ground. They made ladder with the help of rope and bamboo pieces. They discovered how to make candles from waxy fruits and rubbery boots from a tree exuding, that is, giving out a rubbery sap. They also made a sledge to help them to transport materials. When the tree house was being built, the mother looked after the vegetable garden and grew healthy plants. Corn, melons, pumpkins, and cucumbers were already growing. William wished to shift to create a place safe from the elements during the coming winter. So Fritz came up with the idea of a cave. The third place the family decided to reside in was a cave. The cave could also be a strong storage spot to protect themselves and their belongings. The Robinson's family's third home was a cave they carved out in the rock abutting their camping site, that is, having common boundary. They made an opening on the smooth face of the rock. Then they cut windows in the rock to allow for cross currents of air and sunlight to enter the cave. They made four rooms complete with a fireplace. They hung a huge oil lamp at the top of a bamboo pole for light. This was their winter home. The father was very resourceful and knowledgeable. He found plants from the forest which would provide them with wax for candles and rubbery sap for boots. He realized that winter would be difficult in the tree as they would be exposed to the elements. So he worked hard and intelligently to build a cave. If he found that anything was lacking, he tried to rectify it, like providing the cave with a lamp. He cared for and looked after his family well. One day, the family found that one of their huts had been completely destroyed and the cultivated fields around it trampled and ruined by an elephant herd. Hence, they decided to have another residence, which would discourage all wild animals from their cultivated lands. While building it, they took the precaution of using four strong trees growing in a square near one another as a foundation. The trees were of equal size, approximately 12 feet apart. Thus, they built another safe home, also called their fourth home. 10 years passed and the young boys were now young men, and their parents were very proud. They called the island New Switzerland. Many adventures occurred over the years. On the shore of another island, Fritz had knocked down an albatross, that is, a large long-winged seabird. He found a rag tied to the bird's leg. On the rag was a message that an English woman had been stranded on a smoking rock, which was probably a faraway island. William thought smoking rock was a reference to a volcano. Since there was no volcano nearby, they thought the bird had come from 100 miles away. So, Fritz tied a note on the bird's leg where he wrote, "Do not despair, help is near." Fritz then successfully rescued the young English woman, Jenny Montrose. Though shy at first, soon she got used to living with Robinson family. The adventure comes to an happy ending after the family and Jenny were rescued by a British ship sent by Jenny's father. Passengers and crew of the British vessel were amazed to see that the survivors were in good health, and decisions were made without any disagreements about who wanted to stay on the island and who wanted to leave. William, Elizabeth, Jack, and Ernest decided to stay back, whereas Fritz and Franz decided to head to Europe with Jenny. Franz wanted to receive academic education. Fritz told his parents about his love for Jenny and his wish to marry her, so everyone was finally happy. The father had kept a record of all the adventures they had had on the island. He handed over the journals to the captain to be published, and then the ship departed. The end of the story. I hope you loved the story and the explanation. Thank you for watching.